Welcome to Logic Pro Tips in Under 5 Minutes with Ripple Training. I'm Mary Plummer, and I'm going to show you a few tricks for getting yourself from GarageBand into Logic Pro 10. So for starters, I just want to compare the two apps. If you're familiar with GarageBand on the Mac, you'll see that it looks pretty familiar. And if I jump into the Streamlined Interface for Logic Pro, you'll notice they're nearly identical for empty project, other than the default track size is a little smaller. You notice I just zoomed in. Back to GarageBand, you'll see that GarageBand has a library, a tracks area, and then over here we have our loops browser, where we can select loops and drag them right in, and there's our loops. Now you're probably familiar with that. And of course we also have our smart controls and our editors. So that's GarageBand. Let's go to Logic Pro and look at the same thing. There's our library. There's our tracks area. Over here's our loop browser. And this is one a little bit more advanced in GarageBand. I can bring it in, and it'll even allow me to bring in the tempo for my first loop and change the tempo of my project accordingly or not. I have that option. And other than that, we still have our editor. We have our smart control buttons. But there's also a few cool things. For example, in Logic Pro 10, you also have your mixer to allow you to mix your tracks, just like standard hardware equipment, as well as there's your inspector, which gives you easy access to plugins and effects, as well as faders for your selected tracks and your master stereo in and outs. Go ahead and hide my mixer. So let's go back over to GarageBand now and create a new track. As you can see, here's your four standard tracks. I'm just going to make a drummer track. Very cool feature, virtual drummer. Here we are in GarageBand. Automatically, we have two default regions. And you notice whichever region selected as you make adjustments, that's the one that you're going to be editing. Right now, I'm using the default drummer Kyle, but you have all different genres. I can switch over to hip-hop anytime or whichever I like. And there they are. Again, whatever I select is the one I change. Now let's look at the same thing in Logic Pro. There's my drummer track. I can select the genre right there in my new track dialog. I'm going to go with my default Kyle. And I can zoom in and out there a little bit. But look at this. There's also a drum kit designer, which allows me to swap out certain parts of my kit or make adjustments to them. I can change the kit entirely right there in the drum kit designer. Or another Logic Pro feature is I can just go over to the library and select a different kit there. Something else. Let's go ahead and switch over to our hip-hop genre or electronic. Either one also gives you access to the drum machine designer, and there you can swap out whichever instruments are assigned to the different pads. So for example, this cowbell, I can change it to a different percussion instrument just by selecting, and now that will be played as part of my kit. So that's just one subtle difference. I'm going to swap this back to alternative, and let me show you a feature that's only available in Logic Pro 10, and this is brand new. It's right here. It's called the auto select button, and if I would select that, now wherever my playhead is, that region will be selected for my drummer track. So if you take a look, as the playhead moves from one drummer region to the next, you'll see it'll automatically select that region, and then I can make adjustments to it. So very cool, very useful, and saves a lot of headaches when trying to do editing with your drummer tracks on the fly. There's also tools that you'll find to make it a little bit easier to do some of your editing and different recording work. If you go to preferences, you can switch out of the streamlined GarageBand friendly interface to a more advanced interface. And once you turn on the advanced tools, now you have a lot more preferences. You also have more buttons available, more customizable tools that you can shortcut. There's your list view that allows you to look at things in lists. You also have a handy customizable toolbar and a lot of recording options for doing things like punching in or ADR and much more advanced recording work. So when you're ready, you can slowly add advanced features, or if you're just getting started and making the leap from GarageBand, you'll be able to start right away. I also have a full series of tutorials on Logic Pro that you can find at rippletraining.com. This has been Mary Plummer. Thanks for watching.